course, our programme of government is all about creating jobs and growth. It's about ensuring that we support our businesses, we support our young people accessing employment and skills. There are many examples across Wales where European funding has been absolutely vital.
Well, the campus is a modern, forward-looking 21st century university-type campus where we're sharing space with major companies that we work with. This is an economic regeneration project, and European money has been fundamental. And it wouldn't have been possible without massive support from Europe, and that came first of all from the European Investment Bank. And we were hugely encouraged when they looked at what we were doing and said, this is the best project we have seen in the whole of Europe.
Design for Life is a project that we have next door to the hostel. We provide activities there for residents, and those activities are used as a hook for young people to come in and have a look what's on offer. Design for Life, through the Engagement Gateway project, are now able to provide CV writing, interviewing skills, and are introducing people to training, volunteering, which then lead to employment opportunities that they would never have had previously.
I was contacted by my support worker, and he mentioned the IOM scheme with a company called Kilk, which provides a 3-month placement, which is also paid. I went to that. Ended up with a prefab project. This location is all around Cardiff. People can either come into the store and donate clothing, or they can do it through our clothing banks.
European funding has enabled us to engage with the Engagement Gateway project. It's complementing other projects that we have in the hostel, such as our work incentive scheme, prefab, and our recycling centre. European funding has enabled us to run these projects, and it really has made a huge difference to people's lives.
I feel more like me now. The person I remember, before all of this happened, because obviously before all this happened, I'm quite an outgoing, confident person. And obviously for that to be just completely taken away from me, it was really quite difficult. But as I said, in just 1 year, I feel like me again now, and can't really put a price on that, can you?
Well, the difference it makes to Llandudno, to visitors and to the people of Llandudno, is that it actually creates a jewel in the crown, in the jewel of Welsh seaside resorts. And it's something to be really proud of. And we know that when we invest in stations and we invest in the infrastructure, we encourage more inward investment, more tourism. And it's a really welcoming environment now for tourists as they arrive here in Llandudno. It's really important to invest in the stations. These are the shop window, not only of the town that they serve, but also of the railway itself. So Welsh Government funding and European Development Office funding has been really essential to make this scheme happen. Combining that with the funding from the Railway Heritage Trust and from Network Rail and other agencies has meant that we've been able to deliver a first-class scheme that's really befitting of Llandudno itself.
3 nod cynllun ydy i rhoid y cyfle i bobl ifanc rhwng 11 a 19 yn Nogledd Cymru i datblygu sgiliau, cychwyn menter eu hunan, a hefyd dangos iddyn nhw fod y fentrys ddim yn rhywbeth ofnus ac anodd i wneud.
Cysadlais yn y rali ffermwyr ifanc a cyfais gynta, a mae dyna sgrwyddo'n lleol yna, a nath i gofyn nes oedd fi eisiau dechrau busnes fy hun, a nes i jyst neidio ar y cyfle, really. Dwi'n gweld o'n ofnadwy a blesar bod pobl yn prynu gyn hogan 40, oherwydd maen nhw'n gallu trystio bod fi'n gallu gwneud y blodau iddyn nhw. So, safon da.
My name's Gertrude Bovin and I'm a bakery assistant. It's given me a lot of confidence in what I'm doing now. Not just about the catering industry, about myself as well and what I'm capable of doing.
It's really satisfying as an employer to see young people learn a lot of skills and basically become very employable.
She's brought so many different skills to the business. An injection of youth, I think.
Where do I start with Laura? She's fantastic. She's great in the office, she's bubbly, she's full of energy, and she's really enthusiastic.
I'm Nathan Burgess, I'm 22 years old. I've been taken on by Asprey, an insurance company, through Jobs North Wales. Without the support from Jobs Growth, I'd probably still be looking for work now.
My name's Ricky Owen. I'm a general production operative and a maintenance operative with Hydrotech. Without the support from Jobs North Wales, I'd probably still be signing on with the Job Centre.
I would definitely recommend it. I just think it's a great opportunity for young people to have more of a hands-on experience and a more of a practical approach to working.
I definitely recommend the scheme to everybody. It's an excellent scheme.
Well, Wales has been an excellent user of the European Social Fund. Close to 1 billion euros have been invested in the last seven-year programming period in Wales from the resources of the European Social Fund, and they contribute to all different types of projects. This is a very important European contribution to the competitiveness of the British economy, social cohesion in Wales, projects like this one where there is a very well-known international company which is very innovative, hires apprentices in large numbers, helps young people to prepare their future and contribute to the prosperity of Wales.
There's not enough stress put on apprenticeships, to be honest, and a lot of stress is put on the university degrees, but for me this was the best way for me to get into this type of employment and gain experience at the same time, which is obviously what employers are looking for.
The Blennygwart Learning Zone is a £33 million project. Much of the funding has come from Europe, and frankly, without that funding, it would never have got off the ground. It is amazing the difference that good investment in an area like this can make, and we feel that we are making a huge difference to this area. We have a huge range of opportunities for students to come and study here. We also have a huge programme of A-levels. We are now the A-level provider for Blennygwart, and I can say that our first year of A-level results have been outstanding as well. So we're really, really pleased with the progress this is making, and we're sure that we're making a huge difference in this area.
Before we had the fibre broadband, the speeds were very slow. One of the chief complaints was that the internet was dropping off for people. In the 21st century, it's extremely important that we are able to offer fibre broadband to our customers. They want information and they want it there and then. Email, social media, all of our reservation systems now are online. There's a very varied need, whether it's for business use or personal. We've only had it installed for a short amount of time, and at the moment we're seeing the short-term benefits. I don't think you can operate a busy hotel anymore with a slow internet connection, because guests just won't put up with it.
Viability certainly gives opportunities for people who aren't in education or training. Obviously it's difficult to find a job in these kind of circumstances, so for Viability to offer sort of BTEC in sports industries and for the Engagement Gateway course, it gives someone the confidence to go and get a job.
Everybody that takes part gets the opportunity to go on a two-week work experience placement at a professional football club in Europe. It broadens their horizons. They actually realise that there are, you know, other things out there for them that can be achieved.
I actually got to go to Sweden. We went to Umeå. It was nice to see a different way to run football clubs and school sports as well.
Beacon is a five-year, £24 million collaboration between three Welsh universities at Aberystwyth, Bangor and Swansea, and is supported by the Welsh European Funding Office. The main focus of Beacon is to collaborate with a wide range of companies in the convergence regions of Wales in order to generate a range of sustainable products from biomass. This concept is called biorefining. This funding has allowed us to recruit additional staff and invest in new equipment, which is vital in terms of capacity building. But it's also allowed us to create a multidisciplinary team of over 80 scientists consisting of chemists, microbiologists, life cycle assessment experts and material scientists. But from a Welsh perspective, building such a large multidisciplinary team has allowed the project to project Welsh scientific expertise at a UK and a European level. And indeed we're developing links with other world regions, including places like Canada, Brazil, India, China and the US.
We know that the Organisation for Economic and Community Development says you need investment in skills and infrastructures. So we need to facilitate this through the European Union investment, through structural funds, to make sure that we're backing business, backing employment, backing skills, backing our infrastructure.